It has been called the grey ghost of the mountains. The snow leopard, which originated on the Tibetan plateau about 7 million years ago, is today found on the roof of the world and its associated mountain ranges, collectively known as High Asia. But today, the snow leopard's very habitat has become its enemy. On International Snow Leopard Day, let us take some time to reflect on the impact of climate change on this charismatic cat. According to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the average annual temperature in South Asia and Tibet will increase by 3 to 4 degrees Celsius by 2080-2099. Add to that, annual precipitation in the region too will increase. And how will this affect the snow leopard? Well, previous studies have shown that warmer and wetter conditions may result in forests ascending into alpine areas, the snow leopard's preferred habitat. In their 2012 paper, Conservation and Climate Change, Assessing the Vulnerability of Snow Leopard Habitat to Tree Line Shift in the Himalaya, Jessica L. Forrest and her co-authors estimated that under the IPCC's high emission scenario, about 30% of snow leopard habitat will be vulnerable to change along the Himalayas. Even if emissions remain relatively low and begin to decrease below current levels by 2050, up to 10% of snow leopard habitat could be lost. The researchers also predict that if forests creep upwards, species adapted to them, like common leopards, dholes, and tigers, would follow and compete with snow leopards. Snow leopards and their prey species would then have to migrate to even higher reaches. Even more worryingly, anthropogenic threats may be exacerbated under climate change, according to the scientists. How? As alpine habitat shrinks, competition for its resources between livestock and snow leopard prey species would increase, ultimately leading to their local extirpation by humans. The leopards would then have to hunt livestock, which in turn would exacerbate human-snow leopard conflict. So how can humanity help the snow leopard tide over climate change? The authors of the 2012 paper suggest that areas where these animals already exist and are less vulnerable should be identified and conservation efforts there prioritized.
To me, if you ask, the best thing and the most important thing we can do as human beings for the snow leopard is A, to spread the word around that there exists a species such as the snow leopard, which is not just a beautiful species which lives in some of the most beautiful landscapes, but it's a species that is guarding, which is providing, which is like a guardian of what we know as the third pole of the planet Earth, but it's guarding part of a landscape, a part of the Earth which provides water to billions, and I'm not exaggerating, to billions of people living downstream, right? The Central Asian and South Asian mountains, they provide water to a large number of proportion of humanity. So, to begin with, if we get to know what the species is and what is it already doing for us, the amount of services, ecosystem services we are reaping, people living next to snow leopards are reaping because of the snow leopard and the ecosystem that it represents are enormous. And so to me, that's the first step. Step two is, if you know about something, please make your voice heard. Talk more about it. Talk to your family, talk to your friends, talk to your shopkeeper, talk to people, your friends and colleagues. The more people talk about it, the more issues become prioritized rather than being sidelined. And third, if you know about it, if you're talking about it, then we can hope the governments will start prioritizing these conservation issues as mainstream and not something as an optional issue to also deal with or to consider them as hurdles. And that's the key, I think.
A 2016 paper by Huan Li et al. Titled Climate Refugia of Snow Leopards in High Asia also talked about an identified so-called climate refugia for snow leopards. According to the authors, some species survived large climate shifts in the past as they could retreat to zones where they could shelter, persist, and even expand. The authors identified such refugia in an area of 1.1 million square kilometers in the Altai, Chilean, and Tian Shan, Pamir, Hindu Kush, Karakoram mountain ranges. But the most important aspect of snow leopard conservation is transboundary cooperation. The snow leopard is spread across 12 Asian countries. Even more amazingly, according to a 2019 paper defining priorities for global snow leopard conservation landscapes by Huan Li et al., up to one-third of global snow leopard habitat may be located within 100 kilometers of an international border.
Snow leopards, if you look at the distribution range, a large proportion of snow leopard range is within 100 kilometers of an international border. Fortunately, a large chunk of these international borders are not fenced. What it means is snow leopards, they travel between international borders. They travel from India to Nepal, from Pakistan to Afghanistan, also in Tajikistan, from Russia to Mongolia without passports or visas. So in the true sense, they are the ambassadors, not of one country or two countries, but of this entire mountain range. So if you want to conserve snow leopards and do a good job of it, you have to look at the impacts on these international borders. You have to collaborate, you have to share information, you have to look at what's happening right across the border, because for a snow leopard, it doesn't matter where is the international border. It might be walking between two or three countries. If I'm not mistaken, in Nepal, they call it a snow leopard, which was traversing regularly between Nepal, Bhutan, India, and even China for that matter. So snow leopards really don't care about where you have defined your border on a map. What they truly care about is where the mountains are and where they have their food and the habitat and so on. So given that, I think we cannot overemphasize the value of transboundary cooperation for snow leopard conservation. Transboundary cooperation does not mean that we go away with these borders. These are very important borders. Each of them each side is a sovereign country. We're not saying that you diffuse these borders. Let those borders be there the way they are, but let's improve the dialogue. Let's have greater dialogue, not just about security issues, but also about issues of relevance, such as the conservation of a species and then entire ecosystems, because you can't conserve snow leopards in isolation. They have huge ranges. We know a snow leopard in Mongolia would travel regularly to Russia and back. We know a snow leopard collared in Pakistan would regularly travel to Afghanistan and back. I just mentioned about another snow leopard collared in Nepal would travel to Bhutan, India, and so on. We also know a snow leopard collared in Tajikistan would go to Afghanistan and back. So you see, these cats are moving. And if a cat is safe in my country, but the same cat is unsafe in another country, this cat is unsafe, right? So we cannot overemphasize the value of cooperation and dialogue and information sharing between neighboring countries for snow leopard conservation.
If our future generations are to see the snow leopard in its stark, forbidding landscape, governments across Asia have to act fast and act now.